Hello everyone, how are you? Today I bring you the first video of many on how to animate objects in Blender. I'm gonna cover some simple techniques you can use with other objects, and I have more advanced techniques videos coming up. Okay, let's begin. Let's start with this simple animation. First, we need to model the bookshelf. Let's add a cube, scale it down. In edit mode, let's add a loop cut, press escape to place it in the middle. Now in face selection mode, select these two faces and inset face. Enable individual and extrude towards the inside. I'm going to enable cavity so we can see the corners of the objects better. And since I'm gonna need the origin to be on the bottom for the bounce effect I'm gonna create later, we need to select this bottom face. Choose cursor to selected and back to object mode, set the origin to the 3D cursor. Remember that the placement of the pivot point will have an impact on the animation, and if you change it after setting the keyframes, you will have to tweak the animation. Let's enable the snapping tool just to place these shelves a bit faster. I'm gonna change the color of the objects in the viewport and enable cavity just to make things easier to see. Back to edit mode, let's disable the snapping tool and enable X-ray mode to select these two back faces and move them a bit just to make this shelf thinner. And back to object mode, we need to move the shelf again towards the wall. I'm gonna clean up this workspace a bit and leave just this timeline so we can start animating this object. First, let's choose the final frame. Press I and insert a location keyframe. Let's go to the beginning of the timeline. Remember to disable the snapping tool and move the object up on the Z axis and insert a location keyframe. Let's set the end frame to 30 and let's see. A couple of frames after the first keyframe, insert a scale keyframe. And back to frame 1, scale to 0 and insert a scale keyframe. Let's take a look. We could make some changes to this animation. Open up this channel group and let's lock the scale keyframe so we can move the location keyframes right here. And now the shelf gets big first and later it moves down. I actually like it the other way around better, so I'm gonna undo this. But this is so you can see, you can mess around with the placement of the keyframes. You don't need to take everything I do to the letter. We can unlock this now. Let's go to the last keyframe. And remember that we set the origin to the bottom? Well, this is when it's going to be handy. First, let's duplicate these scale keyframes. And let's duplicate them again. And right in the middle, scale down a bit on the Z axis. And insert a scale keyframe. Let's take a look. I want to make some changes, so I'm gonna lock the location keyframes and I want to move these scale keyframes to frame 16. Let's unlock this, select all the keyframes, and here is where you can play with the easing and interpolation modes. You can even change the interpolation mode of only a few keyframes, and you can even create more elaborated effects by using the graph editor, which is what I'm gonna show you at the end of the video, since it's a bit of a complicated process to follow and I don't want to bombard you with that yet. Something we could do now is to clean this animation up a bit. If you take a look, this animation is only animated on the Z axis, and yet we have keyframes for all the three axes. So we need to delete the location keyframes for the X and Y axis by pressing this diamond icon. Go to the next location keyframe and let's repeat the process. We could do the same with the scale keyframes that we made for the bounce effect, since we only need the Z axis to be animated. And as you can see, the animation looks the same, but our timeline is a bit cleaner. Since now we have only keyframes for the Z axis, we could even move the shelf on the X or on the Y axis and we wouldn't need to insert new keyframes. Let's undo this. Okay, now let's model the books that we're gonna use throughout this video. Add a circle, go to top view, and in edit mode, in vertex selection mode, delete half of the circle. Select these two vertices and extrude along the x-axis. A to select all and scale down. I'm gonna move these vertices a bit more to make the book cover longer. Select everything again and rotate 90 degrees on the x-axis, and now extrude along the y-axis. Now select these two vertices and F to fill. And do the same with these two vertices. Now select this edge loop and fill. And let's do the same with these four vertices. Now select this edge loop and fill. In face mode, select these three faces and inset face. Extrude along normals towards the inside, and here we have a pretty simple book ready to be animated. Scale it down and set the origin to geometry. And now we need to place the book inside the shelf. Let's scale it down a bit more. Rotate it 90 degrees on the x-axis. Now rotate it on the z-axis and place it inside the bookshelf. Let's scale it down a bit more. And I'm gonna enable the snapping tool again to place the book. Now we can add a couple more books. Duplicate, escape, and move on the x-axis. Select both books and duplicate again. Instead of duplicating the objects, you could use the array modifier, apply it, and separate the objects by loose parts in edit mode. Let's move the books towards the inside of the shelf. And you could also move some of the books more to the inside and others towards the outside, so they don't look so perfectly placed. Select all the books. We need a couple more frames for this animation. Choose the final frame and insert a location keyframe. Move the playhead back. Move the books outside the shelf, insert a location keyframe, and also insert a scale keyframe. Move a couple of frames back, scale to zero, and insert a scale keyframe. Let's take a look. And now let's create a cascade or offset effect real quick. Place the playhead where the first keyframe is, leave the first book as it is, select the second one, and I'm gonna move 4 frames forward. And with all the keyframes selected, move them towards the selected frame. And let's repeat. You can leave more frames between each animation if you like. Before doing this, you could have cleaned up the keyframes like we did in the shelf animation. And I'm gonna show you how to set a keyframe for one axis only in the next animation. And let's keep doing the same. And let's repeat. Let's see. I'm just gonna organize my project real quick. I suggest you do the same, you're gonna thank me later. Let's put all the books in the same collection. And I'm gonna create a collection for each animation I'll be showing you today. I want to change the speed of my animation, so select the first book and let's move a couple of frames, and I'm only gonna move these 2 keyframes. Now there are 10 frames between the first and the second keyframe. I have to do the same with all the other books, so make sure there are 10 frames between the first and the second keyframe and move. Now we are changing each animation manually, but later I'm gonna show you how to copy an animation from one object to another one, so you don't have to change every single keyframe of each object. Let's see. Okay, for the next animation, I'm gonna model another type of shelf real quick. It's gonna be a wall shelf. So we need to start with a cube. Scale it on the z-axis. Now scale it on the x-axis and finally scale it on the y-axis. I want it to be a bit thinner. And again, using the snapping tool, place it close to the wall. Let's choose our final frame, and since I'm gonna be animating the y-axis only, instead of setting a keyframe by pressing I, or instead of pressing I in any of the transform panels, which will insert a keyframe for the 3-axis, what I'm gonna do is press this dot icon, and now we set a keyframe for that axis only. And now we don't need to delete the extra keyframes like we did for the other bookshelf animation. Go to the beginning of the timeline, move on the y-axis and insert a keyframe again. Let's see. I'm gonna move the keyframes a couple of frames and insert a scale keyframe. And in frame 1, scale to 0 and insert a scale keyframe. Let's move this last keyframe to make the animation a bit faster, and I'm gonna tweak this keyframe a bit so the shelf is closer to the wall. And since we already have a keyframe set, we need to click this diamond shape 2 times. And now we can try out different interpolation modes. Now I'm gonna change the interpolation mode of only these scale keyframes, just to try something different. Let's try another one. And we could move these scale keyframes closer to the first one, so the scaling or revealing of the shelf is more abrupt. Let's move it a bit more. And I'm gonna move all the keyframes just to see the beginning of the animation better. In this version, the shelf appears more abruptly with no scaling effect. Let's go back to how it was before. Now we can duplicate these books we already have, and I'm gonna take them to this new collection. And since we're gonna make a different animation, we need to delete all the keyframes. With the help of the snapping tool, let's place them on top of the shelf real quick. Since later we're gonna link the animation data from one book to the others, I'm gonna apply all transforms to deltas, and now the primary transform values are at 0 and those values are now delta transform values. If you apply all transforms instead, everything might look the same, but the object origin point is gonna be moved to the global origin. I want my animation to last a bit longer, and now pick where you want your animation to end, and since I'm planning on moving this set axis only, let's set a keyframe for that axis only. Go back a couple of frames, move the book on the z-axis and insert a keyframe. Let's move these keyframes a bit, and in the frame where we have our first keyframe, insert a scale keyframe. Move a few frames back, scale to 0 and insert a scale keyframe. Now I'm just gonna see where I want the book animation to start in relation to the shelf animation. And here it is. To copy the animation to the other books, select all the books and make sure the animated book is outlined in yellow. That means it's the active object. Ctrl L and link animation data. And here we have it. And now we need to convert this book's animation data into single users. Otherwise, when we move the keyframes of one book, it's also gonna affect the other books as well. And now we can move the keyframes to create an offset effect like we did with the other book animation. And let's repeat with the third book. Move 3 frames and move this book's keyframes. And repeat with the fourth one. And one more time, let's repeat again. Let's take a look. Now, if we wanted to move any of the books, we simply will need to change the delta transforms and the animation won't suffer any changes. Okay, now we're gonna take this animation into this one with the help of the graph editor. As you can see, the second animation is smoother and it does look a bit more stylized and less stiff. The difference is subtle, but it's there, trust me. Let's select the first animation we made, and you could repeat this process with all the other objects, by the way. And let's go to the graph editor, expand these channel groups, and I'm gonna start with the set scale keyframes. Make sure you lock the other channels, select everything and frame. And we're gonna focus on this part right here that has this shape. Select these 3 keyframes and set the interpolation mode to cubic. And now you should have this sort of shape. Now select the first 2 keyframes and set the easing type to ease out. And now select these 2 keyframes and set the easing type to ease in. And you should have this type of shape. Let's see how it looks. Let's normalize it so you can see the shape better. And you can apply the same technique to any other animation. You might need to choose ease in instead of ease out, and vice versa if you have a different animation. Now let's do the same with the set location keyframes. And this one has a different shape because it's a different animation. Let's select everything, choose cubic, and now ease in. And we should have this sort of belly shape. Let's see how it's going. And to finish up, let's change the easing mode for the 3 scale channels. As you can see, the beginning is the same for the 3 axes, and of course the Z axis has this animation we already have eased. Select the beginning only and set the interpolation mode to cubic. You should have this shape, and now ease out. And this should be your final shape. Let's take a look at the final result, and here we have it. And again, you can do the same with all the other animations we did today, and even take this knowledge to your personal animation projects. And like I said in the beginning, you can apply what you learned today to any type of object. And once you have mastered these simple techniques, you can go for more advanced ones. But that, my friends, is a subject for another video. If you enjoyed this video and would like me to upload more tutorials like this one, let me know in the comments. And if you liked this video, I'm sure you're gonna love this one. As always, thanks for watching and see you in the next one. Bye!